popular Netflix show will no longer follow the order of the books. From the problematic plot to expected changes in Benedict's story, and even some surprising details regarding the central couple of the third installment, here's why Bridgerton Season 3 should skip the next book. Just a fair warning, major spoilers ahead. The central couple for Season 3 is confirmed. It's official, you guys, the third installment of the popular Netflix hit will focus on Colin Bridgerton and Penelope Featherington's love story. The good news came straight from Lady Whistledown herself, and while most fans were pleased to hear the much-awaited announcement, others have decided to express their disappointment about the series skipping the next book. So what exactly happened? Why aren't we seeing Benedict and Sophie in Season 3? What was the main reason for Netflix deciding to skip an offer from a gentleman? Let's find out, shall we? Nicola Coughlan, the amazingly talented actress who plays Penelope and Lady Whistledown, announced that she'll be the female lead character in the third season. During Netflix's FYSEE event, Coughlan revealed that Netflix will no longer follow the order of the books, and she later confirmed this with a black-and-white Instagram post of herself and actor Luke Newton, who plays Colin. Like Lady Whistledown, I've been keeping quite a big secret from quite a long time, but I can finally tell you that at Bridgerton Netflix Season 3 is Colin and Penelope's story, the actress wrote on the post. As you already know, the show is an adaptation of Julia Quinn's novels, with the first two seasons following the order of the books, beginning with Daphne Bridgerton, played by Phoebe Dynevor, and Simon, played by Rege-Jean. The second installment followed by Anthony Bridgerton, played by Jonathan Bailey, and Kate, played by Simone Ashley. The fact that we'll see Penelope and Colin next also means that the show skips the love story of the second eldest Bridgerton sibling, Benedict. For those of you wondering where the third installment is expected to air, production is set to start with summer, and Netflix is yet to announce a release date, but according to most reports, the show will premiere sometime in the beginning of 2023, at the earliest. Now let's get into more details regarding Benedict's problematic story in the novel.
I would never dream of courting Penelope Featherington, not in your wildest fantasies, Fife.
Netflix needed to skip his story, but why? As previously said, the news of the series skipping the much-anticipated novel was a bit confusing, with a lot of fans wondering why we won't see a film adaptation of the third book. While the main reason for this change was revealed by the new showrunner, Jess Brownell, Brownell released a statement giving fans an explanation. "I really feel like it's Colin and Penelope's time, because we've been watching both of these actors on our screens since Season 1. We've already invested in them a little bit. We know who they are as people," she said to Variety, adding that she felt like, "There are these moments of tension between them where it's like Colin walks up to the line of almost realizing that Penelope has feelings for him, but doesn't quite get there. Instead of treading water on that dynamic, we wanted to push it into their season. It really felt like the perfect moment to tee it up, but one thing she forgot to tell, the fact that the third book has a...
I suppose that means they are cutting out.
No, we're not cutting out.
Problematic plot. Now before we continue, we need to assure you that you've absolutely nothing to worry about because the show got renewed for Season 3 and 4. The showrunners also revealed that they'll make a season for each of the Bridgerton siblings, so it's safe to say that the fourth installment will be based on an offer from a gentleman, the third book in Julia Quinn's series of novels, and the story of Benedict. Now his story is a bit different than the love stories of his siblings, and we might see some major changes in the film adaptation, simply because of the plot that a lot of fans believe is problematic. Keep watching for some major spoilers from an offer from a gentleman.
My lord!
Room!
Oh my god, Kate!
Call the surgeon at once!
A Cinderella story. The female lead of the third book is named Sophie Beckett. Fans who've already read the book know that Sophie is the illegitimate daughter of the Earl of Penwood. But her life has changed forever once the Earl marries Araminta, aka the wicked stepmother. Sounds familiar? Oh, Araminta has two horrible daughters too. When the Earl dies, Sophie's life is turned into a living hell. One night, however, she manages to sneak into Lady Bridgerton's masquerade ball where she meets Benedict for the first time. And since we're talking about a woman that is completely different from the rest, Benedict is immediately attracted to her. They meet again. After their first meeting, Benedict vows that he'll marry the mysterious woman he met at the ball. Unfortunately, he's unable to find her, but the most important thing is that he doesn't give up. Meanwhile, when the evil stepmother finds out that Sophie was at the Bridgerton ball, she kicks her out of the house, and Sophie is forced to work as a maid, which is how she meets Benedict again, and when he asks her to work for his mother, he's attracted to her, but he has no idea that this is the same woman he met at the ball 2 years ago. As the story continues, they both fall in love with each other, but the second eldest Bridgerton sibling is focused on finding the woman of his dreams. There's another problem as well. It's the fact that she's a servant, hence she's not a suitable match. Then Benedict makes Sophie his mistress instead of marrying her.
Do you know why I win every time?
Because every time you lose, you claim we cheated.
The ending. Prior to Benedict realizing that Sophie is the woman he's been looking for, he finds an indirect way to ask his mother whether it's fine for him to marry a woman that has a very different background than him. His mother tells him that there are no issues as long as they love each other, but he's still not sure whether he'll do the right thing, and then he finally realizes that Sophie is the one. But before they get a happily ever after, she decides to resign and leave the household. The problems keep coming, with her evil stepmother accusing her of being a thief, which results in Sophie being placed in jail. The Bridgerton saver, with her coming home with Benedict, they get married and 7 years later, readers find out that Sophie is pregnant with their fourth child, so yeah, this is basically the plot of the third book, which according to some readers, is a bit problematic because of Benedict's treatment of the woman he loves. The fact that he makes her his mistress is not something fans want to see in the film adaptation. What do you guys think? Should Netflix stay loyal to the source material? Let us know, and make sure you smash that like button if you haven't done it already.
And understandably so, after forcing you to make an unimaginable sacrifice, he wanted a life with children. A family.
Changes in the story. Most fans who have watched the first installment of the series ended up with a conclusion that the second eldest son of the family is either gay or bisexual. So is this true? Should fans expect a different story that will maybe feature Benedict and Stefan instead of Benedict and Sophie? Well, thankfully, actor Luke Thompson has already addressed these questions. He admitted that he's not sure whether his character will get involved in a queer storyline. He told Town & Country, "I tend to think that's a question for the writers, really, because in order to be playing a character, I sort of have to surrender that side of my brain. The writers are like God, as in I just have to play with what they give me. I think there is that openness, which is really lovely to play with, but in terms of where it goes, I don't know." According to Chris Van Dusen, the showrunner for seasons 1 and 2, the storyline with him and Henry in season 1 was never supposed to indicate that the character is gay or bisexual. He told TV Line that the storyline of him befriending Henry was really about tolerance in a really intolerant time, and showing Benedict in that world. We're not sure whether Netflix will play with the character's sexuality in the fourth installment, but we would love to hear your hopes and theories. Share them in the comment section below. If you enjoyed our video, make sure you subscribe to our channel so you'll never miss any of our videos in the future. As always, thanks for watching, guys!